Merrily is one of those shows that if you have any interest in musical comedies, it's fixed in your imagination as this kind of glorious failure.
It was very upsetting to have to write about it.
In hindsight, there are plenty of reasons why that original production fared the way it did. I think the collaborators, and I think they've acknowledged this, weren't all making the same show.
I saw the documentary, The Best Worst Thing That Ever Could Have Happened. That was my first sort of intro to the show. And I cried so hard watching that.
When I was going through the process, I couldn't help but think about the original cast going through what they went through, and they were very young.
The closing notice, many in the cast were crushed. I know I was disappointed, but thrilled that we were going to do the recording. Even then, I felt, well, it'll run forever.
If I had like a time machine and I could go back and be like, you're laying the groundwork for legacy, like your pain and your struggles and your what you sacrificed in this, you're actually laying a groundwork for a really fertile legacy that is going to live on and on and on.
It was a whirlwind, thrilling, hard work, disappointing, triumphant, but over 42 years, the watercolor memory is that I was the luckiest man in the world, and I'm grateful that I was a part of it.
When you have your heart broken by something, you either walk away from it or you keep going back to it. But I think Sondheim really wanted to fix it.
You know, it went through a lot of iterations. Lapine did it at La Jolla. Doug Wager did it at the Arena 5 years after that in 1990. Lester Haymarket, which had Maria.
When they came to Lester Haymarket, George and Steve, as far away from the New York critics as you could possibly get, to see what they could make. And they infused us with this sense that this was the masterpiece. And I really saw from their eyes the joy, the humor, the love, the detail that they approached the work with.
But it still never had the kind of connection to an audience that it did when Maria introduced it at the Chocolate Factory.
When I went to see this new production I'd heard was good at the Menier Chocolate Factory, I thought, yeah, I'm sure it'll be fine. You know, they try so hard. And I was suddenly moved by the show that I'd always kept at the distance that you keep curiosities at. I mean, this was Maria Friedman.
Steve saw this production. He saw it and he wanted it in New York. And 10 days before he passed away, he, out of the blue, made an announcement in the New York Times that Maria Friedman's Merrily We Roll Along was coming to Broadway, unbeknownst to us.
Yes, yes.
Because he was absolutely determined.
Maria, in and of herself, is like a great director, but also having her there as like a conduit to Sondheim in some way, because she knew him. So she knows that he's actually not precious about stuff or moving things around. Like, she let us play around with stuff more than I imagine future productions will feel that they are able to.
She would constantly give us these gems of things that Steve and her would talk about with the show and things that they changed and why they changed them. So we really kind of got to also know like the history of the piece and how it started and why they changed what they changed, and it was so invaluable to have that.
Here comes this woman who had worked with Sondheim as an actress, as a singer, and said, we're not going to interpolate things, we're not going to make it meta, we're just going to look at the emotional center of it and take it very seriously. And it worked. I mean, that's the miracle of this show. I can't think of another of an equivalent to it, really, in Broadway history.
I think that this show strikes people in a very personal way.
I've never heard a audience response like this when it's over. I've never heard anything like that.
It's extraordinary. The letters, the phone calls, the people that stop us in the street and stop us at the back of the stalls and the orchestra at the end of the evening, saying, I've got to go and phone my friend. My friend.
I had my college best friends come. My friend, I saw him after the show and he was just weeping. He was like, could not speak. And he was like, yeah, that was us on the roof. Like, that was us.
I can just see Steve sitting there. You know, when we broke even, he would have taken me out for one hell of a meal.
I would love to see his reaction because he's so pessimistic about the commercial, and rightly so, about the commercial aspects of Broadway. I think he'd love it, and I think he'd be like, Holy shit.
It's amazing. I mean, what kind of redemption story is that? It's legend. I mean, it's already legend. It's just acquired that.
The second time I saw the revival uptown, I went with, maybe there were a dozen of us from the original cast. And there's a feeling of love and pride. That's what I felt. We were saying, you see, it was a hit then, and it's a hit now. We're a part of this great piece of theater. So I think if anything, it's a healthy pride and love for each other and for that time in our lives.